Hi again, everybody. We are here again with our weekly chat with Cobb County Commission Chairman Mike Boyce. And I did not get the memo today that it's casual dress day, but I know you're dressed that way for a reason.
That's right. I try to do ride-alongs with our public safety departments, the sheriff and police department, at least every 3 weeks. But I think I've been doing a little bit better than that since I started in January. So today I'm riding with District 3. I usually go for 3.5-4 hours. Depends on what happens at the end of that time frame. If they're involved in some special case, then I usually hang around there. But I think it's just a part of my effort to get down to see where our employees work. So I've been doing this now since January. I think this is my third ride-along with District 3. I had a pretty exciting ride-along with the Sheriff's Department last month, where we were serving warrants and arresting a number of people. But I've also been with Viper units, the Viper unit, which goes after special cases here. So again, I think the county would be very, very proud of the public safety and why this county is so safe and how committed these professionals are.
As I know, that's a different view when you get to go out with those men and women and see what they do. Has anything surprised you on those ride-alongs?
If anything, not been surprised. I've just been really, really reaffirmed in how good our public safety officials are. These are incredible young men and women. Although I was with an officer up in Precinct 1 a couple months ago. He retired after 20 years in the Army, and then he finally did his lifetime dream of becoming a policeman. So he's in his 40s right now, but I swear I thought he was like 25 years old. But I just cannot say how good and well-trained and professional and committed these young officers are to serving the public and make sure they get the best service possible.
Yeah, and I'm sure they're on their best behavior when you're on the road.
Well, but the reason I go for 3 or 4 hours is they get a little more relaxed.
Yeah.
Because they now know that I do this. I sit over there on the right side. I stay in the car as much as I can just to see what they're doing every now and then. I'll get out if it's not going to impact on how they do their duty. But you want to see what's going on with the troops, as I say, and it also lets them see what's going on at the top level of this county, what the board is doing and what we're thinking. Because when I tell them, I know they're going to tell 10 of their friends, and their friends are going to tell 10 people. So it's another way of us getting our message out to the staff here in the county.
And speaking of, getting to know the staff in the county, you've been doing that in your first year in office.
Right.
And you've been seeing some things you said that's opened your eyes as to who works here in the county.
Absolutely. I was down in Augusta last week for a conference involving county commissioners. But I got back Friday afternoon and made the mistake of stopping in my office to pick up something. And then 2.5 hours later left, because on my desk was a stack of over 500 certificates of appreciation for our county employees for this year. And what we do is we sign certificates of appreciation for 5 years of service, those are the increments. And let me just give you an interesting statistic here. I signed over 500 the other night, but this year I've signed over 730 certificates, totaling 10,205 years of service to this county. And one of those certificates was for 40 years of service, two of them were 35 years of service, and 23 were for 30 years of service. Now, I spent 30 years in the Marine Corps, so I know what 30 years of commitment to public service means. And we have 23 men and women who feel committed to this county for 30 years. And I'm guessing that most, if not all these 23, they're not retiring. They're going to continue to serve. And I think that the 10,205 years is a number that other counties around here would absolutely kill for, to have that kind of professionalism. And that's why it's going to be very difficult for me to see where everybody works. But tomorrow, I'm spending all day driving around looking, visiting the various water treatment plants here in Cobb County that the county owns. And everywhere I go, there's two things that get my attention. First of all, these are committed public servants. All right, they recognize that they might be able to do better somewhere compensation-wise. But they are committed to this county, and they love what they're doing, and it's a family where they work. And the second thing is that they are truly trained professionals. I think one of the legacies that Mr. Hankerson, our former county manager, has left here is he developed this growth program, for a development program for leaders and managers in this county. And I am seeing that at all levels. As you look at our directors, you know, at the top level and the mid-level, many of them are graduates of our Excel class program, which develops these leaders. And that's why this county is as good as it is. You know, these county staffers, they make the board look good. I mean, we set the policy, but they execute it. And as I tell every one of them and I at the orientation, how you do conduct yourself at the window at your job, you are in fact portraying the best or the worst of this county, because that's how the county visitors and voters and taxpayers see it. And the reason we have this great reputation in this county as the place to want to work, safely live, recreate, and pursue your dreams is because of our staff. And like I said, this is just one small segment. Next year, there's going to be another 10,000 years of work I'm signing for. So I cannot say enough good things about our county staff. I wish I could pay them more, and I'm working on that, but we're doing everything we possibly can to let them know that we appreciate and recognize their commitment to this county.
And when you and I were just sitting here talking before we started taping here about the work that goes into some of what the board ends up doing in the public light.
Absolutely.
And there was a lot of that this last week.
Right.
I sat through the zoning hearing and you could see that there's a lot of work that has gone into what product came out of that meeting.
Yeah, that's a great example. Sunday, what I usually do is a Sunday before the zoning hearings, and certainly the Sundays before agenda prep, I sit down with the binder and I read all the material that's in there. And for the zoning hearings that were on last Tuesday, I'm gonna take a guess. Let's just say the binder was about 5 inches thick. And there's a lot of staff input there. There's letters from the developers. There's letters from people who are supporting the development and those who are opposed. There's a lot of detail in there. And so when I sit down at the zoning hearings, I'm prepared because of the fact that so many different agencies and parties are involved in this process. And what I'm seeing right now is, like, for instance, on Tuesday, we had a lot of cases, but we were done pretty much after about 2.5-3 hours. Many of the cases were on consent because they worked with the commissioners, they worked with the surrounding neighborhoods, and there was no opposition to the development. So if there's no opposition, there's really no need to play out that thing in a regular agenda. Now, I did pull one out involving some apartments that could be student housing, because I wanted everybody to see that there's a lot that goes into this, and it had some issues that I want everybody to see that, you know, you might want to remember that if this development, when this development comes to reality, why we did what we did, and you see it on a video. Obviously, if we do consent, you can read the public record, but to see the board commissioners go through all the issues in conjunction with the attorney and the developer, that gives it some depth and some 3D dimension that you don't normally see. So what I'm seeing right now is that the developers, property owners, communities, civic associations, they all understand now how the process works. They understand how this board is going to react to a development, and they understand what it takes to get the board to approve something. And we went through a lot of cases on Tuesday because I think everybody's now in sync about what it is that that motivates this board and what gets their interest. And that also involves, I want to say, we overruled a couple of Planning Commission decisions because we want to work with people that are trying to establish a business in Cobb County, and they're asking for variances. So we worked with them to encourage them, there's some issues here, but we're going to give you a chance to succeed, all right? We believe in entrepreneurship here, and we're going to see what we can do to help you. We're going to put some limitations, all right? It's not open-ended. You got to come back in a year, and we got to make sure you're doing as you said you did. But I think the message is out there that this is a place that we want to bring you. We want you to build your houses. We want you to build businesses here, and we want you to build commercial developments.
In a lot of what you just said, I received a lot of calls about the Mountain View Elementary site.
Sure, right. Mm-hmm.
And that was one of those where the neighbors had a lot of concerns.
Absolutely.
But by the time it got to the zoning board, those concerns had been ironed out.
You know, that's going to be a great point because people forget that the Planning Commission sees the cases, I think, 2 weeks before we do. So in the interlude between the Planning Commission and when the board meets, if the Planning Commission has some reservations or recommends denial, that gives the developer and the interested parties 2 weeks to address those concerns. So when I go through my records and I read the documents, there are a lot of things that have happened since those documents were put together in that binder. Even 4 or 5 days makes a huge difference. I remember for the Kennesaw development. The President Olin's at Kennesaw State University had concerns about the development, but during the hearing, it was brought out that his concerns had been addressed and he approved of the development now, okay? He at least had no major objections to it. Same thing here is that in that 2 weeks between the Planning Commission and the board, there's a lot that goes on there. So when they come to the board now, they've addressed those concerns and allowed us to look favorably upon the project or not.
Right, and I think where we are now compared to 5, 6, 7 years ago, mm-hmm. it lends developers to working with the neighbors
right.
because if they don't build there, somebody else could step right in.
I think that one of the major influential factors in a board decision is the surrounding neighborhood support or opposition, okay? Now, I don't want to say specific cases because I don't want to get involved in some lawsuits here. But I do know, having sat now through 8 zoning hearings, that the voice of the people is heard by this board. And I'm not just talking about the zoning, but also at the board meeting. There are things that have happened at these board meetings that 2 people can get up there and make an appeal to us that we need to address something, and 3 or 4 months later, we've passed an ordinance to address that. This board listens to the population, they've listened to the taxpayer, and we do all we can to try, you know, and address their concerns.
And that's even if they can't come to the meetings.
That's right, absolutely right. And if they're not there, the commissioners make a special effort to explain, to take their position as to how they would have said something if they'd been there.
And I know the district commissioners and yourself, if you receive the complaints, they are shared among
absolutely.
Members of the board.
Absolutely. You know, as I tell people every time I give them my business card, this may be a county of 740,000 people, but we're not too busy to answer your phone calls or to get back to you by email.
Right. All right. Well, listen, be safe when you're out down in Precinct 3.
Okay.
We'll be listening to see how many arrests are made down there. In the meantime, we will be back next week with more from the chairman.
Okay. Thank you, Russ.
Thank you.